This is how people do it now, Nikki. They have their interviews on the internet.
I like it.
I know Charles.
Okay, here they are. Now, when I hit this, yeah, they'll be able
straight,
to see us. So come on in, get in here close so we can be seen in the webcam. See how small the webcam is? No, get your cheek. Nick, come here.
Okay, but don't crown me.
We can see you guys.
Okay, great.
You got us?
Hi, my name is Billy.
Oh, we can hear you fine as well.
Oh, great.
Good.
Billy McMahon.
Nick Campbell.
I'm Benjamin.
Allison. We're going to ask you a few questions that some of our candidates find a little bit odd.
Let's get weird.
No judgment. Shoot.
You're shrunken down to the size of nickels and dropped to the bottom of a blender. What do?
You take her flat on your
back
like this.
You just lay back, enjoy that breeze.
Board, feather,
pretend it's a fan.
And let those bad blades whip all around you like this. It's like getting an MRI.
Once this blender's on, it's on forever.
It's on.
Respectfully, I gotta disagree. We sold blenders, and even the best model in the world is only gonna run maybe 10 or 11 hours. So we're getting out, and when we do, we're better off for it, because whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger.
It's not so much getting out of the blender, it's what happens next. That's the question.
You've got two nickel-sized men free in the world. Think of the possibilities.
I mean, I'm top of my head and I'm just
spitballing here. My head's swimming.
Sunglass repair? We'd be hell on those little screws.
Or maybe stick us in those submarines that they put in people's bodies to fight diseases.
Okay, that's not a real thing, the submarines.
No.
Wait a minute. I thought we were stuck in a blender. Now we're saving lives? What?
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 What? What?
Let me just recap this for you real quick. We start off in a blender.
Yeah.
Now we're saving lives. What?
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 Wait a minute. We were stuck in a blender.
What a journey.
And now we're saving lives? What?
You guys led us to this. Thank you.
I'm okay.
Sitting out there for the last half hour trying to come up with a story that would explain my being here dressed like this. And I wanted to come up with a story that would demonstrate qualities that I'm sure you all admire here, like earnestness or diligence or team playing to something. And I couldn't think of anything. So the truth is, I was arrested for failure to pay parking tickets.
Parking tickets?
And I ran all the way here from the Polk station, the police station.
What were you doing before you were arrested?
I was painting my apartment.
Is it dry now?
I hope so.
Jay says you're pretty determined.
Oh, he's been waiting outside the front of the building with some 40-pound gizmo for over a month.
He said you're smart.
I like to think so.
And you want to learn this business?
Yes, sir, I want to learn this business.
Have you already started learning on your own?
Absolutely.
Jay.
Yes, sir.
How many times have you seen Chris?
No, I don't know. One too many, apparently.
Is he ever dressed like this?
No. No. Jacket and tie.
First in your class, in school, high school?
Yes, sir.
How many in the class?
12. It was a small town.
I'll say.
But I was also first in my radar class in the Navy, and that was a class of 20. Can I say something? I'm the type of person, if you ask me a question and I don't know the answer, I'm gonna tell you that I don't know. But I bet you what? I know how to find the answer, and I will find the answer. Is that fair enough?
Chris, what would you say if a guy walked in for an interview without a shirt on? And I hired him. What would you say?
He must have had on some really nice pants.
So, why do you think you'd make a good pharmaceutical sales rep?
Well, I'm a people person. People like me. Some of my favorite people are people. I feel like I'm saying people a lot. People, 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 people. Okay, I'm done.
You sure?
People, yes.
Good. So, how do you feel your previous job experience has prepared you for a career like this?
Well, as a waitress, sales was a big part of my job. I mean, believe me, I convinced a lot of very large customers who should not be eating cheesecake to have more cheesecake. I mean, one of those chubsters even had an insulin pump.
I have an insulin pump.
People.
All right, let's say a physician was prescribing one of our competitors' drugs. How would you convince them to switch to ours?
Any chance his car needs to be washed by a girl in a bikini? Okay, I'm really sorry for wasting your time.
Don't worry about it. Thanks for stopping by.
Okay, thanks. I'm sorry. Listen, could you do me a favor and not tell Bernadette how badly I blew this interview? She'll get upset, and honestly, I'm a little terrified of her.
You're scared of Bernadette.
Yeah, kinda.
I thought it was just me! Everyone thinks she's so nice with a squeaky little voice.
I know, but she's kind of a bully.
No, but she is. I didn't even want to meet you, but I was too scared to say no to her.
Me too!
Well, you know, one time, I had to tell her we were cutting the research funding for one of the drugs she was developing.
What happened?
I couldn't do it. She's still working on it. Oh, we're not going to tell her about this, right?
Oh, my God, no.
On my company's transition from the KL5 to GR6 systems.
You must have had your hands full.
That I did.
So let's talk a little bit about your duties.
My duties? All right.
Now you'll be heading a whole division, so you'll have a lot of duties.
I see.
But there'll be perhaps 30 people under you, so you can dump a certain amount on them.
Good to know.
We could go into detail.
No, don't, I beg of you.
All right, then. We'll have a definite answer for you on Monday. But I think I can say with some confidence, you'll fit in well here.
Really?
Absolutely. You can relax. You did great.
I gotta say, thank you. I was really nervous. You know, I've been told I come on too strong, make too many jokes, you know, and then it was really hard to sidestep that duty thing. Duties. Duties! poo.
Poo?
Oh my God, this doesn't count. Okay, the interview was over. That was the real Chandler Bing in there. This is just some crazy guy out in the hall. Call security, there's a crazy guy out in the hall. Poo. I look forward to your call.
Who are you?
My name is Andy Sachs. I recently graduated from Northwestern University.
And what are you doing here?
Well, I think I could do a good job as your assistant. And, I came to New York to be a journalist and sent letters out everywhere and then finally got a call from Elias Clark and met with Sherry up at Human Resources. And basically, it's this or Auto Universe.
So you don't read Runway?
No.
And before today, you had never heard of me?
No.
And you have no style or sense of fashion?
Well, I think that depends on what you're...
No, no. That wasn't a question.
I was editor-in-chief of the Daily Northwestern. I also won a national competition for college journalists with my series on the Janitors Union, which exposed the exploitation of... Yeah, you know, okay. You're right. I don't fit in here. I am not skinny or glamorous, and I don't know that much about fashion, but... I'm smart. I learn fast, and I will work
very hard. All right,
I've
got the exclusive on the Cavalli for Gwyneth. But the problem is, with that huge feathered headdress that she's wearing, she looks like she's working the main stage at the Golden Nugget.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for your time.
Who is that sad little person? Are we doing a before and after piece I don't know about?